And from Central Maine Community College in Auburn, Maine, it's YSCC Women's Basketball. Tonight, the Mustangs of Central Maine welcome their in-state rivals, the University of Maine Augusta Moose. I'm Jim Toomey, along with our producer, Rob Munzing, Andrew Severson on the camera. And we'll also have a men's game starting about 8 p.m. between the same two schools. Looking at these two teams, very familiar with each other. UMA coached by Heath Cowan in his third season, assisted by Peter Dixon and Ty Cowan. Their record 16-4 overall, 8-2 in the conference, 6-4 at home. They are unbeatable on the road, 7-0, 3-0 at neutral sites. The Moose score 72.2 points a game while giving up 52.1. They shoot 41.6 from the floor, 28.4 from long distance, and 68% at the foul line. Their last two games were against Paul Smith of New York, beating Paul Smith 80-48 and 76-50. And they played the Mustangs back on November 7th at the Augusta Civic Center. Central Maine 66, UMA 53, and that was once upon a time, to say the least. Central Maine Community College head coach Andrew Morong in his 11th season, assisted by Abby Nielsen and Tia Day, 19-2 overall, 9-0 in the conference, 12-0 at home, 5-2 on the road, 2-0 at neutral sites. CM scores 76.6 points a game while giving up 44.1. They shoot 37.8 from the floor, 24.5 from behind the arc, and 60.7 at the foul line. They're coming off a very good win against CCRI, ranked very high, in the other division, defeating the Knights 62-52 last Sunday. Rob Munzing, we welcome you in as well. Of course, you cover the Moose as part of the Munzing Media Sports coverage, and you obviously seen both of the Moose teams tonight coming in here.
Well, Jim, they've been on a run here. They're really in full gallop mode, to take a little bit of analogy from the Mustangs, Jim. The Moose have been playing very, very well here, and they've ripped off, I think, about 12 or 13 in a row as they come in here tonight to take on your Mustangs. Want to let our folks know from Moose Land that tonight is a Mustang magic call for us, but of course we love both our teams that we get to cover here. Absolutely, Jim, the Mustangs will be in for tonight against a really, really good Moose team, as they feature Desiree Dume as their primary outside shooter. Desiree has been player of the week in the league already this year. Out front, Allison Alley is the point guard. She's out of Stearns High School, and she'll handle the pressure defense of the Mustangs here tonight. She's an excellent ball handler, very good distributor. Down low, they've got Katie Butterfield, the southpaw. She gets down on the blocks, gets her a spot. She's very quick. She's got very good feet inside and really knows how to finish in the block.
Well, Butterfield's a four-year player, so she's been part of this resurgence of UMA women's teams.
Exactly. Mariah Dunbar is another player who's been player of the week here in the YSCC. She's out of Skowhegan High School and played her basketball in a very competitive situation, Class A North. So Mariah also is an inside-outside type game. You'll also see Haley Paquette off the bench, as well as newcomer Tamara Ellis. And I'm missing one off the bench. Let's see, it's Bree Dume. She can come off the bench and hit as well. Sydney Farabi, the other starter. She is an excellent all-around player, Jim. Hits the inside, drives well to the basket. So this is a good Moose team. It's going to be a good matchup.
Because as I said, the Mustangs coming off that big win against CCRI. I say it's a non-conference, but ranked very high in Division III of the junior college ranks. Of course, the Mustangs will play a lot of people. People that follow with Coach Andrew Morong, they'll play up to 12 or 13 people in any situation. Emily Strawn has been a player of the week this season in the league. She comes in averaging 14.2 points a game, and followed by Luna Love with 9.1. We're trying to get Coach Morong on for a few comments before the game. But a lot of people will see action for the Mustangs playing a variety of roles. But one thing looks consistent, the pressure defense.
So we're made connections with Coach here. Might have to focus, Andrew, on Coach. There we go. We'll take the shot now. So, Coach, big game here tonight. Your concentration's elsewhere other than getting our interview, I know. We appreciate you coming over and coming on with us.
I saw my family walk in, so I had to, you know, sprint over there.
Yeah, you definitely want to be able to do that, that's for sure. So, Coach, as we get ready here in the pregame, certainly you know you've been scouting, probably taking a look, at least with one eye, what the Moose have been doing. They're on an impressive run here. You've got the one game early on in the season. You must be thinking, hey, this is playoff time now.
Yeah, it really is.
I mean, it's been so long since you played them.
Yeah, it's kind of like a barometer to see where both teams are at, you know. And they're, 13 wins or something like that in a row, playing fantastic. Their starting five is just as good as any starting five in the Yankee Conference on any given night. So, you know, definitely never a team we can take lightly. So, no conference games are easy, especially when it comes to when you're playing UMaine, you're playing Southern Maine Community College. Those games are never going to be easy. So we got to be ready to go. I told our girls, you're going to get a championship effort out of the Moose tonight.
Yeah.
So if you don't bring yours, you could be in trouble.
Well, that's why you want to look at it this way right here at this stage of the season. And you only have to go back to last year. They were very competitive against you and was able to knock you off. But certainly a different year this year. Noticing the starting lineup, Moran getting the start here. Janiyah getting the start here, Coach, tonight.
Yeah, kind of a drastic change. But, you know, Janiyah's been playing well. We haven't been able to give her a ton of minutes the way we want, way we should have been probably or wanted to. And we just told the players, like, last week, like, you never know. At this point of the season, everyone's going to have a moment. You don't know when that's going to come, so you got to be ready for it. And tonight's Naya's moment. You know, she's an incredibly hard worker, incredibly confident kid. We want her to go out there and help create havoc on defense and really help us push the tempo because that tempo is key tonight and making both teams flex their depth because I think that's where we have a significant advantage.
Okay, Coach, we'll see how it all plays out. Thanks for joining us.
And, thank you.
Good luck tonight.
All right, we're about 3 minutes away from the opening tip. And we can almost say down the stretch they come. Rob, where did January go?
Remarkable, huh?
February 1st today, and both the Mustang teams after tonight going quite a road trip and return for one more regular season home game 2 weeks from tonight against the Southern Maine Seawolves. It's just amazing how fast it goes in January.
Well, we know it getting towards the end of the year and getting towards playoffs. When we start miking up the coaches, we've got Coach Morong miked here tonight. So we'll be able to bring him in.
Hey, about time, huh?
You're hearing Coach down interacting with the officials as well. Hey, I want to make note of something here to them tonight, Jim. Today marks the 37th National Girls and Women in Sports Day. So the achievements of girls and women in sports continues to lead her forward by acknowledging the power of sports unlock unlimited potential in women. Central Maine Community College supporting that with a post on their social media page as a husband of a wife who played two college sports at Northeastern University, softball and field hockey, just about when Title IX was coming in. I certainly am appreciative of Title IX and all it's done.
Thank goodness, and thanks for bringing that up. I mean, even in the Maine high school ranks, the high school girls didn't get into official MPA tournaments until 1975. They had county tournaments, they had other stuff. I mean, to people listening, oh, that's a decade. I'm just telling you, it was so long overdue. And sports like field hockey and girls' soccer in high school were late coming, at least to the state. And also some of the facilities as well weren't the same for the boys and girls of high school or the men and women at the college ranks. So.
Well, you should hear my wife talk about how they used to travel and be put up back in the early 70s for what are now major sports.
Well, some places in Maine, you know, through the 60s, it was like, get off the court. Here comes the varsity boys basketball
right,
team.
Right, exactly.
All right, we're going to go Patrick Dexler.
Oh, pro at this, huh?
Sounds like he's rapping.
He's rapping, yeah. The Patrick rap. So we're going to have the national anthem first. So let's get our camera set across the way, Jim.
How many cameras tonight, Robert?
Three tonight. This is the one that's on the video board, and that's the one that'll play the flag for the national anthem. That was Dave Gagne's suggestion, so, you know, we worked on it, made it work, and happy to be able to do that for the folks at home that can't see the video board. See the starting lineup.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. We ask that you please rise and remove your hats as we honor America with the flag of our national anthem.
Our national anthem.
Once again, good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Dave Gagne Court at Kirk Hall on the campus of Central Maine Community College for tonight's YSCC women's basketball game featuring the visiting University of Maine Augusta Moose. And your Central Maine Mustangs! The YSCC promotes good sportsmanship by student athletes, coaches, and spectators. We request your cooperation by supporting the participants and officials in a positive manner. Profanity, racial or sexist comments, or other intimidating actions directed at any of the above parties will not be tolerated and are grounds for removal from the site of competition. Here's the starting lineup for the visiting Moose. From Litchfield, Maine, number 5, Desiree Dumay. From Charlotte, Maine, number 13, Sydney Farr. From Millinocket, Maine, number 23, Allison Alley. From Monmouth, Maine, number 24, Katie Butterfield. And from Canaan, Maine, number 34, Mariah Dunbar. The head coach of the Moose is Heath Cowan. The assistant coach is Peter Dixon. The student assistant is Ty Cowan. Luna Love. From Waterville, Maine, number 11, Kelly Thompson. From Oxford, Maine, number 13, Jay Smedberg. And from Lewiston, Maine, number 23, Emily Strong. The head coach of the Mustangs is Andrew Morong. The assistant coaches are Abby Nielsen and Tia Day.
All right, should be a great night of basketball here.
Let's go in the huddle and see what coach got.
Okay, because something with our backboard lights don't
start with an administrative technical foul on Central Maine.
People don't take care of stuff.
There'll be
right?
one free throw for the University of Maine Augusta.
Just use it. All right, you know what we need to do. Let's go out there and do it.
Okay. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go.
One, three. One, two, three.
And then it'll be a jump ball, and then it'll be the regular jump ball. Yeah.
So technical foul to start the game. We'll get it from Patrick Dexler. Well, something about the LED bar lighting up when it's not supposed to. I have no idea what that means and why that is the situation. Why is that a technical foul?
All right, the foul shot was missed. You're talking the shot clock, are they?
They said the LED around.
I still don't know.
I don't
anyway,
know. Play ball.
Mustangs going left to right in the white uniforms. There's a three-pointer by Love. Bang! 7 seconds into the game. 3-0 Mustangs.
Sometimes you better be careful what you ask for.
Three-pointer. Farrar rattles in. Bang!
Back-to-back threes.
Thompson looking around outside to Smedberg. Left of the foul line extended. Love. Smedberg behind the arc. Starts a drive. Strong changes hands on the dribble. Goes inside and travels.
Well, already keeping me busy on the replays, Jim. Two threes to replay. We got a second.
In the lane, Butterfield. Baseline shot is good by Katie Butterfield.
Yeah, Katie's really good down that left side, Jim.
Monmouth, Maine. Monmouth Academy. 5-3 Moose. Janiyah Moran getting a well-deserved start. Left out of foul line extended. Skips over to Smedberg. Smedberg shot is blocked by Butterfield. Taken away by Butterfield. Allie has it. Allison Alley passes to her left to Farrar. Baseline, Butterfield tries to get through, has to go back outside. Butterfield got it back. Butterfield takes a deep block by Smedberg. A loose ball taken by Love. Strong on the far side. Baseline to Thompson. Rotated around to Moran. That's Love in front of us for three. Spins off, rebound bounces around, tracked down by the Moose in the person of Allison Alley. She has the basketball. Dume. And contact. Got an illegal screen against the Moose.
The Luna Love three to get things started. Sydney Farrar came down and matched that. We'll show you Sydney's in a second.
Moran drives. Moran takes it to the hoop. High off the glass and good. Janiyah Moran with a great drive and finish. We're tied at 5. 2:15 into the game. Down the lane, Dunbar. Dunbar goes back the other side. Left-handed shot, no good. Rebound, Strawn.
Wow.
A little contact there we play on. Love left on the foul line extended. Love on the drive. Smedberg, no good. Down the other way. steal by Smedberg. Strawn to Moran. Moran drives, kicks it back out. Strawn fakes. Strawn drives, scoop shot, off the glass, no good. Rebound, Dunbar.
Pace, Jim, wow. I think this is the pace that both teams are very comfortable with. They really want to get after, and they are.
Allison Alley swings it far side to Dume. Alley gets it back, overshoots. Rebound, Moran. Smedberg. Strawn, little contact. Strawn take it all the way in, and they call traveling.
Well, Moran's in there to bring energy, and she brings energy on this one. What a drive and a finish.
Oh, the finish was tremendous.
Just what Coach was talking about when he talked to us in the pregame interview. He said, hey, pace is going to help us. We really want to put the pace at a high level, and they have. Both teams playing well.
Alley being watched by Strawn. Now it comes out to Dunbar. Swings it over here for a three. No good by Butterfield. Rebound, Smedberg. Strawn into the lane. Has it knocked away. And travels. The subs coming in for both teams. For the Moose, number 35, Ariana Alcid, sophomore from Westbrook. Mackenzie Melendez, 21, in, along with Clara Bands in there, 24 for the Moose. There's a drive up and good. And guess what? It was the other player coming in, Chantel Ouellette, that gets in the scoring column about 5 seconds after she's into the game. Mustangs by two.
Fast!
Out behind the arc, dribbling around. Is Alley. They skip it way down the right baseline area. Comes back here. There's a shot from outside. Rattles off. That was Haley Paquette, 25. She's from Smithfield, Maine, Madison Area High School. The Madison Bulldogs.
Speaking of Bulldogs, we got more Bulldog action tonight. Our other game in high school tonight. Nate Munzing up running the show with Rob Kennedy on play-by-play. Big one. Spruce Mountain Halldale.
Munzing Media, teams, they're everywhere.
Both those teams with 13 wins on the season.
Wow. Band for three. Bang! Clara Band about 3 feet behind the arc. Drained it for a 10-5 CM lead. Down there deep, Dunbar. And what are they going to call? Foul on Dunbar. Third foul, Mariah Dunbar.
Here's the Band banger.
Let's see. Desiree Dume is in there along with Allison Alley, Haley Paquette, Ariana Alcid. With the ball, Band by the Mustangs. Driving baseline, Smedberg, she's shut off. And another player control. Rob, how many offensive fouls, either player control or illegal screens, have we had so far in the game?
Yeah.
I'm going to say at least five.
Is that something that's on the live stats? Not sure. That's a good accompaniment for people that are watching at home to put up the live stats.
Oh, definitely. Alley being double teamed. Dume outside on the drive. Farrar back out. Faking is Alley. Loose across the lane. Picked up by the Moose. That was Farrar. 10 to shoot.
Seven.
They look underneath. And traveling on UMA.
Well, hectic pace leading to some turnovers. Coach Cowan into it tonight.
Yeah, the referee just said that's enough.
Yeah.
There's a three-pointer. Bang! Clara Bear with a big smile. She comes off for a 13-5. Central Maine lead, 4:04 to go in this first quarter of action.
Let's go in the huddle.
Hey, put her at the top of 12. All right, you go deep. You're at the top. Hey, if you're the alternate trapper, you got to take away that middle. That middle advanced pass is you. We don't care if it goes behind and away or equal underneath, right? Let it go back. Right, same with 22. They're getting that middle cutter every time. We got to load up on ball side, right? We got to box up. Box up on ball side.
Well, listen, Coach, let's look at the Clara Band, second of her threes.
Look for that middle pass. The tempo is great. Right, the tempo is exactly what we want. They're falling right into it, okay? They can't sustain this. Keep up the tempo. Sprint the floor. You got subs coming in a minute. Go.
Tempo's just what we want, says Coach.
Yeah, well, he definitely has more depth through the lineup. I mean, I think 9 Moose are dressed tonight.
Yeah, the Moose are continuing to build. They've got 3 players out, I think 2 or 3 players out of Lawrence coming in. Savvy Brown, excellent player out of Gardner High School next year.
Tamara Ellis checking in, number 2.
Ellis, a second semester player, just joined the club.
Valdosta, Georgia.
I told her to make sure one of the players takes her over the marketplace in Augusta, gets her some long johns for the weekend.
No, hardly any heights on the UMA roster.
Tenacious defense there by the Mustangs.
Hey, in the rip.
On the possession arrow, it's Moose ball. Dume lost out.
Coach might not be long before he's down the alphabet to the letter after S.
Willette down the lane. It's going to be UMA ball. Excellent defensive effort by the Moose. Thompson coming back in, replacing Smedberg.
Desiree Dume, one of the premier scorers for the Moose, really haven't been able to shake loose yet.
Over half court, here comes Ellis. Parquette, double team, maybe a triple team. Ellis coming out of the corner, shoots short off the side rim, and lost out by the Mustangs.
It was 5-5, 8-0 run here for the Moose, Jim.
That is true.
I wouldn't say if it wasn't true, Jim.
Oh, okay. truth is a scarcity these days, so when somebody tells the truth, you're shocked.
Although, I never let the facts stand in the way of good story either, so I,
It's always easy to remember things if you tell the truth, right? Turnover Moose.
I put people in a conundrum, which is a prison somewhere, I believe.
Oh, dear. Hey, it's only the first quarter of the first game, folks. Jeepers. Rob, you must have more stuff. Well, let Elizabeth Barrientos, number 12 in from Manchester, New Hampshire. Her pass stolen away in the front court. Kazali to Ellis. Ellis stops, shoots, comes up short. It's going to be UMA ball.
7 for Dez.
Goes way out. The pass got tipped to Ellis. In the middle of the lane, all kinds of traffic. Gonna call a foul on Luna Love. Emily Strawn returns for the Mustangs. Coming out, Chantel Willette. Inbounding, Allison Alley. Desiree Dume on the drive. Marientos picks up the personal. Inbounding Alley. Cutting to the basket, Alley, she lays it in. Excellent execution. for the Moose. Yeah. Off the inbounds.
Ellis, a late cut to the basket, found herself wide open.
Down in the corner, Barrientos. Barrientos shut off. Now she swings around, gives the ball up to Strawn. Stops, shoots, bounces off the backboard right in the hands of Tamara Ellis. And possession arrow to the Mustangs. 2:20 to go, first period. CMCC 13, UMA 7 on Munzing Media Sports. Strawn. Love on the drive. Banned for three. That one got the rim. Rebound right to Desiree Dume. Outlet pass to Allie. Dume got it back. Second foul, Luna Love. Smedberg returns. Moran returns. For the Moose, Sydney Farrar returns. Moose inbounding. They come back outside, rotated around to Paquette. Paquette goes and is fouled.
Offensive foul, Jim.
All right, it was. Who held her ground down there?
Moran, right. I believe. I'm going to look at it in the replay,
Jim. All right,
Jim.
Look at the replay. Rob will get back to us.
Yeah, it was Janiyah. We'll take a look at it, Jim.
Near steal, banned for three off the rim or right in the hands of Sydney Farrar. Allie will bring it up. Moran, the defender. That's stolen away by Strawn. The Moose getting back. Strong change of pace on the dribble. Strong has it deflected out. Excellent defense. The Moose, they really collapsed that time on Strawn.
There's a Moran take there. Brought the bench to its feet.
Mackenzie Melendez in. Comes way out to Ouellette. Ouellette in the paint. Baseline to Smedberg. Smedberg high off the glass, bounces around. Rebound. I think that was Paquette on the rebound. Ellis on the drive. And it's going to be CM ball. So for the Mustangs, it's Thompson, Smedberg, Ouellette, Moran, and Melendez. Thompson has it. Back out to Moran. Moran on the drive, kicks it to her right, but nobody home. Moose ball. Desiree Dume checking back in.
Yeah, they're really playing tight on Dume, and I think what Coach wanted her to do was take it to the basket. Since she's done that a couple of times, she's drawn some fouls, Jim.
Dume from Litchfield, Maine, Oak Hill High School. The Raiders. Poked away by Thompson. For the first time for the Mustangs, number 25, Raina Duzant, 5'9 sophomore, St. Albans, New York.
We've seen Raina getting more time in the games that we've done here recently. We've done a lot of games recently, Jim.
Yes.
It's been great. I love my dorm room.
Off balance shot by Dume. Bounce off. On the drive, spins out. But going to the line will be Chantel Ouellette. Ouellette gets one more. And she's now 8 out of 11 on the season, just joining the team second semester.
good all-around ball play, Jim.
Yes, it's been a great contribution. Here's a steal by Moran. Janiyah Moran fakes, shoots, and scores! Moran used her speed to get down there. Then she used her head to wait for the defender to fly by. And there's the end of the first period. At the end of this first quarter, YSCC women's action. Central Maine 16, University of Maine Augusta 7 on Munzing Media Sports.
Athlete brand advisor and CEO of Pliable. Pliable helps high school, college, and professional athletes build their athlete brand. New name, image, and likeness opportunities are a game changer for athletes and for businesses. To learn more about social media marketing and endorsement opportunities for your brand, visit PliableMarketing.com or call 1-707-PLIABLE.
All right, back here at Kirk Hall on the campus of Central Maine Community College. Jim Toomey, Rob Munzing, Andrew Severson on the camera. 16-7, the Mustangs over the Moose. UMA, 3 out of 11 from the floor. CM, 6 out of 14 from long distance. 1 out of 2 Moose. 3 out of 7 Mustangs. 6 points for Clara Band, the lead scorers in the game. Ball deflected, Mackenzie Melendez. Melendez fakes, goes up, and is going to shoot two. A first-year player from Saco, Maine, out of Thornton Academy. Melendez averages 5.5 a game. She's 13 for 15 at the line. Again, as we've referenced other games, some of the averages and categories for the Mustangs is not as high as other teams because they don't play as many minutes. So you have to always take that in consideration. 1 out of 2 for Melendez. 17-7. And traveling in the back court on the Moose. Just 26 seconds into the second period. Melendez directs a little traffic, hands off to Moran. Ouellette looks down the lane, nothing happening there, so she gives up a dribble, goes to Moran for three. That one just grazed the rim. And I think they're going to get Reyna Duzant in the rebounding action. Here's Destiny Mora Lopez, the 6-foot sophomore from the Dolls, Oregon, coming in. She's been on the injured list. She played a little bit against CCRI, but only about 3 or 4 minutes, as I recall. Great to have her back in the lineup. A very good inside player, both scoring and rebounding. That ball's thrown in the back court. And Melendez is the first one to get there. Mora Lopez down deep. In the middle is Ouellette. The floating shot. Swish! That soft touch once again by Chantel Ouellette. 19-7, Mustangs. They pass it baseline, the Moose dude. Paquette shut off. Out top the Farrar. Desiree Dume stops, shoots, does not get the roll.
Nice passing here by the Mustangs. And Ouellette, as you said, Jim's got that nice touch inside. Floats it up.
19-7, Ouellette. Near side to Strawn, who's returned. Band swings it left on the foul line. Duzant Changes hands on the dribble. Loses it. And we're going to have a tie-up. It's going to be Moose ball. Thompson returning for CM, replacing Duzan. And the Moose throw it away. Led on the drive. Deflected pass went to Strawn. Strawn across the lane. Willette got her back. Willette stops, shoots a little too long this time. Rebound, Desiree Dume. Here's Allison Adley. Here's a shot from this left side. It rattles off by Farrar. Rebound, Maura Lopez. Quickly, band to Willette. Coming out of the corner, and a foul. Nice sportsmanship. There's the Moose help up. Emily Strong. First foul, Allison Alley. Baseline inbounds play for the Mustangs. Still 20 to shoot. Band for three. High off the rim. And whose ball? Officials are going to talk this out over, I guess. They're going to say Mustang's ball with 20 on the shot clock. Mariah Dunbar, 34. Returns for the Moose. She's from Canaan, Maine, with the Skowhegan Area High School. Baseline jump shot. No good by Maura Lopez. Rebound Moose. Desiree Dume gives it to Alley. Farrar goes baseline with it. They skip it near side. Mariah Dunbar is fouled.
Hey, 77.
Ball comes in. On the drive is Alley. Baseline they go. A little too heavy on the shot is Butterfield. Trying to keep it alive over there. And Chantel Willette grabbed it. And a quick timeout for the Mustangs as we keep it right here.
Yeah,
Mustangs,
we'll go in the huddle.
19-7.
All right, help side comes from help side on that. If they press, we're in Duke here. All right, let's go corner.
Andrew's giving it a look at the huddle from upstairs.
Wait for the screen.
And we've got Coach Wrong Mike here.
Wait till they get to half. All right? Go set that screen. Wait for the screen. Your angles are all messed up on your screens. We're setting flat back. Point your butt where you want them to go. Okay? Come on.
Let's go. We got it. 3, 1, 2, 3.
See ya.
ABC. Always be coaching.
Oh, yeah.
We've got some coaches out in the audience watching. Bob Witz, I'm sure, Coach Witz loves being in the huddle. Mike Gammon, former coach at Gardner. Basketball play for the Gardner Tigers. I see Mike's watching. Like that in the huddle stuff, right, guys?
Well, he's instructing and teaching. He's not scolding, you know. I mean, it makes use of it. And that was a 30-second timeout, and he got some points in. Here's a three-pointer out of the corner. That's long by Thompson. Smedberg got it. Nice block by Butterfield, but the Mustangs somehow got it back. Down the lane, Clara Band off the rim. Here's a breakaway. Allison Alley catches up to it and is going to shoot two. First foul, Emily Strong. Allison Alley, a 68% foul shooter coming in.
Yeah, low score and tilt, Jim.
Millinocket, Maine, from Stearns High School. I should look at how many. I did some radio games from Stearns.
That's back when they had crystal sets, Jim?
I'll tell you a story about that in a second. Foul shot was good. Nicely done. Strawn stops, shoots. Get deflected out of bounds, so CM will retain possession. A warning on the Moose bench. Thompson goes down the lane, has it taken away. Butterfield. Alley. Off the rim, no good by Desiree Dume.
That's still a good shot for the Moose. Dume's a outside shooter. She got to keep chucking those up. She's going to get hurt.
Yeah, your shooters have to continue to shoot. As I said, it's a phrase, when you're hot, keep shooting. If you're not hot, keep shooting till you are hot. If you are one of the designated shooters, so to speak. Down the lane, Desiree Dume, contact, and a player control foul. Second foul. Down the lane, Strawn travels.
Let's take a look at that charge, Jim. I'm going to slow it way down for folks at home. Let them officiate a little bit tonight. What do you think at home?
Dunbar to Butterfield. Butterfield back to Dunbar. They're over half court, just barely. And a foul on Elizabeth Barrientos.
Well, you know, one of the things with the great depth that the Mustangs have, they can throw, it's like throwing spaghetti at the wall. You know what I mean? You keep putting kids in there, and you let them play aggressively, and if they get two or three fouls, hey, you're okay with it.
You also can say, you're getting in there for 2 minutes, go full bore, because you're coming out, we're going to rotate you back in. But go full bore for the time you're in there. Another turnover, Moose. Moran replaces Barrientos.
Unless things heat up, Jim, you'll have the quickest stat show in the history of Munzing Media.
Moran, left on a foul line extended, out to Band. Smedberg sets a screen. Band goes the other way, stops, shoots, does not get the roll. Rebound, Butterfield. And possession arrow.
Jump ball. Possession remains Mustangs.
5:01 remaining, first half, 19-9. Central Maine.
We've got this game out everywhere. It's on the Facebook pages of the Moose. It's on the Facebook page of the Mustangs. It's on Boxcast. It's on YouTube. What we do with these crossover games of the teams that we cover, Jim, we put it everywhere.
Into Melendez, takes it deep. Excellent interior defense for the Moose. UMA trying to make a run during the last 5 minutes of this half. Handling the ball, Allison Alley. Dunbar stops. Desiree Dume, baseline Butterfield. And let's see. Butterfield's going to go to the foul line.
I think you were blocked out with Melendez, Jim. Watch a little trickery. Off the defender, got it back. Went up, but as you said, excellent inside defense by the Moose.
Would we see that the other day?
Yeah,
CCRI.
We saw that the other day, too.
Katie Butterfield from Monmouth, Maine. Monmouth Academy.
And we want everybody... Don't partake of any of these scammers or after your credit card. Next thing you know, you're paying for air flight down to Puerto Rico.
0-2 for Butterfield, who came in actually shooting almost 76%. Willette, three-pointer Melendez. Almost banked it in, but it was a little too heavy. Alley being pressed in the backcourt. And they're going to call the foul on Melendez. Two shots.
Say hello to one of our favorite outside shooters in the games that we've done here at Kirk Hall. Kristen Huntress watching, Jim. Boy, couldn't she ring it up from outside.
Quite an outside
what a
attack.
Player.
That group had quite an outside
oh
attack.
Oh, my gosh. She and Alex Bessie. And what a team that was. The Runnels Rappers. What a team. We had some fun with that.
Oh, yeah. Allison Ellie, 68% shooter, was 2-for-2, 100% during that trip. Timeout, UMA. 4:22 to go, first half. Central Maine, 19. UMA, 11 on Munzing Media Sports.
You're a point guard, you're a point guard, and you're a point guard. Yeah, there's no ownership of what's going on out there at all. All right? Our mistakes and poor shot selection, all right, are because we don't have ownership out there on offense. You guys got to be vocal leaders. Period. All right? That's what we need out of our point guard. We have yet to score a point this quarter. All right? We are losing 4-0 right now. Come on.
Coach reminding everybody what their role is. Trying to get some points. This has been, what did I call this the other day, Jim? A Charleston chew. It's like getting a Charleston chew in your teeth and yanking on that thing.
Well, actually, they scored three. Because it was 16-7 at the end of the first period.
Okay.
Thompson goes down deep. And she hit the deck. It's going to be UMA ball.
This is a well-disciplined Moose team. They know how to break the press. See how thoughtful they are with the basketball. Got to get it over, though.
Yeah, they had 3 seconds left. Goes to Dumay.
One more!
Way down in the corner, bringing it out is Alley. Three-pointer, no, by Dunbar. Rebound, Thompson.
Good line on it. Just didn't get down.
Moran, change of pace. Thompson down there deep. Gave it to Ban. Ban baseline. Overshoots. Grabbed out of the air by Desiree Dumay. Dumay being chased by Smedberg, keeping up with her. Alley. They get out on the corner, the Moose do, and they go back over to the other side to Dumay. Alley. Back to Dumay. 10 to shoot Moose. On the weak side, up and in. Katie Butterfield, excellent execution. Excellent execution. Pass from Katie Butterfield across the lane.
Yeah, when Butterfield gets down on that block, she's very tough to defend. We'll take a look at that next dead ball.
Strong being watched by her counterpart, 23, Alley. Thompson has it. Moran to Strong. Strong baseline, but passes it to the other side, out of bounds. Moose get it across. Dunbar has it. Gives up her dribble, has to find help. Thompson guarding her. Plenty of time to shoot. They go inside. There's a block. Strong block Butterfield. UMA will have 10 to shoot as they inbound from their own baseline area.
Perfect timing and athleticism by Emily as she went up, got a pee, all ball.
And there's a foul away from the ball on UMA.
I think we got the Butterfield finish back a bit ago down on that left block where she's very, very good. Ball's going to come into her up and in.
Here's Thompson. Thompson has to get rid of it. Goes outside to Strong. Strong fakes. Tries to create. Score the basket! One more coming for Emily Strong.
You had the operative word there, Jim. Create. right here. Emily, right side, gets cut off pretty well, goes up, draws the contact up and in.
And completes the three-point play.
Nicely done.
22-13, Mustangs. Dume double-teamed over there. Dume shoots. No good. Rebound, Thompson. Here's Moran to Band. Band backs out a little bit. Moran swings it over to Strawn. That's Smedberg coming out of the left corner. The ball gets deflected. On the court we go, and what are you going to call first? Something going on first. Official's going to talk it. Official's talking it over.
I think Dume had the original block. Nick Daigle's got the call. Double foul. No shots.
So Thompson got the foul on one side. Dume. So then they went to the arrow, correct?
Yes, for possession. Yeah.
With the ball is Dunbar. Double teamed over there. Nice catch by Farrar. Moussaf tend to shoot. Way out top to Alley. Alley being watched by Band. Alley on the drive. And she's going to shoot two. She got the shot off with about 2 seconds on the shot clock. Alley will shoot two. 68% of the at the line. She has 4 points. One out of two for Allison Alley. 22-14. Mustangs are leading the basketball. Mackenzie Melendez calling signals. Band skips it over to Strawn. Band got it back and stepped out of bounds.
On the line.
32 sliding to stop the shooter.
Moose in the front court. Here's Desiree Dume. Goes in. No good. Rebound Thompson. Band to Melendez. Melendez takes it deep. Has to go under the basket. Thompson to Band. Band tees one up. Bang! Boy, that one looked good leaving her hand. It looked even better coming down through. That barely tickled the net, Rob.
The third Band banger. Jim likes to call those three-point shots bang.
Well, it's been a long time. You know, Johnny Most did that originally. You know, everything is borrowed. You know that, Rob.
I still use tricky dribble every now and again, Jim.
Yeah. I do, too. There's a nice move up and in for Allison Alley.
Alley, what a nice power drive. Uncontested.
Shot clock is off. Game clock at 12. Let's see if the Mustangs get a good shot here. Underneath is Band. Melendez for three. No good. Rebound. Just move. And that's going to be no basket. So, back and forth we went. A lot of action. Among other things. At the end of the first half, this YSCC women's matchup. Central Maine 25. UMA 16 on Munzing Media Sports.
Have you heard about free college?
It's free.
It's free.
It's free.
recent high school graduates from the classes of 2020, 21, 22, and 23 can attend CMCC for free. The free college scholarship pays 2 years of tuition and mandatory fees. No income or age limits. What are you waiting for? It's free.
Leaving CM with no debt is going to set me up for my future.
Visit cmcc.edu/free for details.
The Hutchinson Family Sports Foundation is proud to support Munzing Media's production of live streaming high school sports. We recognize the hard work and dedication of Maine's high school student athletes, and we applaud Munzing Media's pioneering live streaming efforts. The Hutchinson Family Sports Foundation.
Same thing as always.
Pass the front of the net.
All those little things to make you what you are.
Jim, 1, 2, 3,
0. Okay, let's go. 1, 2, 3.
Sit right here.
The New England Aviation Academy is Maine's only official service training center and service training partner. NEAA is strategically located at the Brunswick Executive Airport in beautiful Brunswick, Maine, which is on the Atlantic coast and only an hour to the mountains in the western part of the state. The aircraft used by NEAA to train our students and rent to current pilots are all technically advanced airplanes, have the Cirrus airframe parachute system, and are the newest model generation. We train in the best equipment in the marketplace, which not only ensures clients are learning to fly aircraft the industry is utilizing on a daily basis, but also is the safest and most reliable. NEAA's facility at KBXM includes a spacious heated hangar, classroom space, and a private briefing room, which make for an optimal learning experience. So, come fly our 2021 Cirrus SR20 and experience the Cirrus life.
I was just blown away.
This is insane. It just caught my attention immediately.
This is the first place that I've seen like this decked out. It's pretty sweet.
This is a grand opening for our esports arena.
We're talking 1,600 square feet of pure technology.
Like, I'm shaking being here. It's so cool.
There's nothing like it in Maine. We're ahead of the curve here.
It's definitely a big market, something you can make a living on.
I've always had an interest in esports.
We're treating it like an extension of our athletic program. And then in addition to that, we're starting an esports management degree program.
It's just a different community for me to be a part of.
It really just helps me just be myself. It's just really fun.
This will bring students together.
That's what's happening, and that's what esports is.
To me, it's beautiful, and I want to live here.
UCLA provides our program exactly what they say, a chance for small colleges to peak. It's leveling the playing field for everybody. We'll be right back.
know, just the fellowship amongst athletes, you know, get a chance to play against some different people that typically don't get a chance to play against from different regions, different parts of the country. It kind of gives you an opportunity to kind of see where you're really at against everybody. We good, like I said, just a great environment, well-ran tournament. It's a pleasure to be part of organizations like USCA.
Helping people is kind of ingrained into me. I am so glad that I chose to be here. It's a really great program.
The instructors are super helpful.
They really do set you up to be successful in the field.
The new hospital simulation lab here at CMCC is a great addition.
It's as close to replicating real life as you can get.
We did an IV lab.
With a mannequin, it's nice to get your toes wet before you jump into a clinical setting.
Deep breath.
CMCC is the best place to start nursing.
It's challenging, but you are learning.
Have a smaller size classroom, smaller ratio to instructors.
It's affordable.
It really provided me relief that I'm not going to accrue a lot of debt.
I needed to set myself and my family up for success after.
I'm going to come out of this able to actually practice as an RN in the real field. It's a wonderful opportunity.
Forensics has grown so much, and it's very beneficial to the criminal justice system. I was always one of those kids that watched Forensic Files. That was something I loved. Just a science person all around, I always have been. The instructors are some of the top forensic experts in Maine. They really know what they're talking about. They've been there, done that. CMCC is very lucky to have people like this. I'm an intro to criminal justice and criminal law and report writing. That's a lot of the baseline of things I have to be knowledgeable about. I want to do crime scene photography. The forensic science program is preparing me to start thinking, like, what's important here? What do I need to look for, like, right off the bat? You never know what you're going to find.
Coaches know you can't win a game without proper planning and execution. Let Gosline Retirement Planning coach you into a confident retirement. Here at Gosline Retirement, we provide that proper planning and help you utilize a step-by-step approach on all facets of your retirement planning. We provide guidance on income planning, wealth management, understanding taxation, Medicare and long-term care, and legacy and estate planning. We pride ourselves on working hard for those who have worked hard their entire lives. So, schedule your appointment today and let the team at Gosline Retirement Planning put together a retirement game plan for you.
Hey everyone, Travis Mills, partner at CBU Benefits, coming to you today to explain a little bit more about the packages that we offer. Today I have Alex, and we're going to go ahead and we're going to cover critical illness, why it's so important for you to have it, what it means, and we're going to find a way to get you covered through CBU Benefits.
So one of our more innovative products that we have is our critical illness policy. Now for us, it's called Active Care. It's a lump sum product from $5,000 all the way up to $100,000 for cancer, for heart issues. Really, it covers 28 critical illnesses. So we call this our Active Care product. So for just a few dollars a month, you can cover yourself for life's unexpected events of cancer, heart, the 28 critical illnesses, even going into diabetic amputation, Alzheimer's disease. So come over to CBU Benefits and get information about how you can protect yourselves for life unexpected events.
All right, welcome back to Central Maine Community College. Jim Toomey along with Rob Munzing, Andrew Severson on the camera. Halftime, this YSCC women's matchup. Central Maine 25, University of Maine Augusta 16. Checking the team stats, the Moose shot 5 out of 21 from the floor. Central Maine 9 out of 32 from three-point country. The Moose 1 out of 5. The Mustangs 4 out of 12. Foul shooting. UMaine Augusta 5 out of 9. Central Maine 3 out of 5. 10 turnovers for the Mustangs, 14 for the Moose. Total rebounds, the Moose have a 1 rebound advantage, 16 to 15. individually for UMA, Allison Alley, 7 points. 4 points for Katie Butterfield. Sydney Farrar, 3 points. Tamara Ellis, 2. Also seeing action, Desiree Dume, Haley Parquette, Brianna Dume, Mariah Dunbar, and Ariana El Cid. For Central Maine, Clara Band leads the way with 9 points, all coming by the way of three-pointers. Chantel Willette, 5 points. Janiyah Moran getting a start tonight has 4. Luna Love and Emily Strong have 3. Mackenzie Melendez has a foul shot. Callie Thompson did not score, but she has 5 rebounds. Elizabeth Barrientos saw action along with Jade Smedberg and Reina Duzant, as well as Destiny Morrow-Lopez had a couple of minutes of action. Let's see some other players for Central Maine we have not seen yet. Jemiah Nicholas remains on the injured list, a sophomore from Lewiston. Maya Nicholas, number 3, we may see at some point. She's from Lewiston. Kirsten Lyons, number 5, is a junior from Mexico, Maine, Mountain Valley. Victoria Sjogren is a freshman from Stockholm, Sweden, number 14. Nikki Clark, number 15, is a freshman from Auburn. Winnie La Rochelle, number 20, is a freshman from Rangeley, Maine. Kyla Moore, number 44, is a sophomore from West Palm Beach, Florida. Let's see, who haven't we seen for the Moose? Autumn Freeman is injured. It's a first year from Byron, Maine, out of Mountain Valley High School. I talked to her briefly before the game saying, every game I go to, I see somebody with a brace or a boot or with crutches. So I wished her the best. Let's see, anybody else has not seen action. I guess everybody else has seen action.
So, Jim, we got some clarification on that technical at the beginning of the game all with right. Patrick Dexler. It had to do with the LED lights that are up around the baskets. The only time those are supposed to come into effect is when the clock goes off at the end of the game, like situation. Well, they came on when they sounded the horn for the two-minute mark, and it's kind of a self-reporting situation for the home team. It's not supposed to happen. Patrick self-reported it as the officials also saw it. So it's a technical foul on the home venue, and that's the home team.
So 2 minutes to go in the warm-up.
Right.
Okay.
When they hit the
clock. That's why it had, because the technical happened before the game started.
Right. Yeah, so it was at that time
okay.
when the horn went. Those lights aren't supposed to come on only when the horn goes off to signify the end of the game. So that's what Patrick Dexler shared with us, and we were as confused as you folks were at home. So, well, it's been a taffy pull game, and some serious frustration has manifested itself both in the crowd and I think with some of the players, coaches as well. So it's one of those things you gotta get through it. There's no easy way to do it. I've been there, Jim. I know. About frustrations with things. Control what you can. That serenity prayer that Mom taught us all is a good one for these situations, Jim.
I see Winnie La Rochelle starting the second half, the 5A freshman from Rangeley, number 20. I think everybody else the same. There's a move inside. The shot is missed by Allie, but Katie Butterfield right on the spot laid it in on the putback. Moran, far side to Band. Strong behind the arc, swings it to Moran. Moran takes it all the way, lays it in. Janiyah Moran turned on the Jets. 9 point. Mustang lead once again.
Well, that's the energy coach wanted out of Moran.
There's a nice play getting it. The roll in was Butterfield. Nice pass, 3-pointer. No good. It was missed by Strong. Again. Allison Alley. gets a partial screen. Alley, the floating shot off glass, no good. Butterfield got the rebound. Katie Butterfield's come out strong this half.
Here's Moran taking off. Right here, beats the defender off the dribble, beats Dume. Gets the shoulders in front, and off she goes. Let's get the scoreboard on there, Rob. There, the boy.
Farrar being watched by Strong. They go to Butterfield, left, coming in from left baseline, hung on the rim. Rebound Mustangs. Moran quickly in the front court, deflected, stolen away. Dume has it. Dume through traffic, no good. And Desiree Dume will go to the foul line. Try to get her first points of the game.
I think it's on the floor, Jim. I think it's going to be inbound, yeah.
I think you're right. Now that I see the official step out of bounds.
Yeah. Pushed after the shot attempt.
Chantel Ouellette in the game for CM, replacing Callie Thompson. Butterfield looks around. And that ball's deflected in the lane. And Ouellette has it. Here go the Mustangs, leading by seven. The floating shot, good! Chantel Ouellette.
That's Chantel's shot, Jim. We're seeing it more and more, that little mid-range pop.
Thrown away by the Moose. Off the rim, left-handed by Moran, or rather by Strong, I beg your pardon. Here comes Allison Alley. Moran, the nearest defender. In front of her own bench, that's Dume. They go inside to Butterfield, a little bit off balance. Rebound Strong. Banned for three, overshoots. Rebound Butterfield on the weak side. Farrar took a pass from Dunbar. Farrar still has it. Allison Alley, hands off to Dume. Underneath, baseline jump shot is good by Allison Alley. And the Moose been working that left baseline area in a number of different ways, Rob.
Well, Butterfield came out early on, hit back-to-back baskets. We're going to huddle with Coach.
You can't get the ball tipped from behind. What's your job when you have the ball? Go to the freaking bathroom, right? Go until they make you stop, okay? Come on, guys, go. We got to play some outside defense. Come on.
We got kind of a tournament-type atmosphere here, low-scoring game. Teams getting after each other. A harbinger of things to come. No fouls on the Moose, two on the Mustangs in the early going here. 3 minutes in.
Mackenzie Ouellette in the game has the ball. Mackenzie Melendez, I should say. Ouellette to Melendez, right at the foul line extended, out top to Ouellette. She backs out. Banned over in the corner to Strong. They dump it in to Duzant. The turnaround Duzant, no good. Rebound Strong. Double teamed, has to go back outside. Ouellette with the shot. Off glass and good. I'm not sure she called it, but it's going to look great in the scorebook for Chantel Ouellette.
A crash, boom, banger.
Back up to nine. Alley being watched by Band. Dume goes out top to Butterfield. Driving down the lane, Farrar kicks it back out. Alley, 10 to shoot, Moose. Alley is held, and it'll be a baseline play, inbounds play for the Moose.
Chantel Ouellette with a spin around off the glasser. No other way to describe it.
Alley to inbound. Dunbar. And a bumping foul on Clara Band.
Yeah, clearly saw that as Ferrara got knocked right in front of the camera down there. That's a stationary camera we got mounted up down there.
Second foul on Band as Luna Love comes in. Pass comes out. Got loose. Here's Melendez ahead of the pack. Lays it up and in. Mackenzie Melendez. She has good speed, Rob, as
gosh,
well as Moran. Down the other way, sneaking away and laying it in was Mariah Dunbar. Here come the Moose across the lane. Ouellette leaves it a little short. Duzant, the rebound, doesn't go, but Reyna Duzant will shoot two. The sophomore from St. Albans, New York.
Watch McKenzie get after it here. Boy, does she fly. Comes out of the blocks. Picks it up. Not easy to control that basketball either, Jim, and she was off to the races.
Duzant scored 77 points on the season, 3.9 average. And two for two, and Duzant was shooting only 37% before that, Rob, so.
Reyna getting a little more opportunity to play, Jim, and she's cashing in on those opportunities. Got the start in the game we did a few games back.
Deflected. The Moose get it back. And there's a drive. Player control foul. Third foul on Haley Paquette. They love Melendez, Ouellette, Duzant, and Strawn. Love has it. Skips it behind the arc. Strawn dribbles in, backs out. Ouellette. Strawn stops, shoots, does not get it. Rebound, Desiree Dume. Dume across half court. Allison Alley being watched by Love. Halfway through the shot clock, Moose. They dump it in baseline to Butterfield off the side of the rim. Rebound, Duzant. She gave it quickly to Ouellette. Ouellette is fouled as she dribbled across the lane.
First of two games tonight. Men's action will follow. The two men's coaches, I'm looking across the way, Dave and Paul, talking it up. Paul Piscopo's done a wonderful job with this UMaine men's program. Took over under some trying circumstances last year as interim. They made him the head coach very quickly and put his stamp on that program.
Tamara Ellis, number two, back in for the Moose. Strong fakes, strong drive, scoop shot strong, leaves it short. Rebound bounces around. Tracked down by Love. Love got it back from Duzant. Love working baseline. Nice catch over there by Strawn. Melendez, no good. Rebound, Moose. I think that was Ariana Alcid with the rebound and knocked out by Central Maine.
Yeah, Ariana, not a high scorer, but she comes in, plays good floor work, good defense, good rebounder as well.
Stolen away down court. Ouellette was there. Love for three. Short. Bouncing out of bounds, a UMA ball. Moran back in for the Mustangs, replacing Melendez.
Chantel Ouellette's had some impact on this game in a lot of ways, Jim.
And there's a foul against the Moose.
Shouldn't there be contact first? Was there any contact at all?
Well, coach is asking if there's contact. I think we'll see that there's contact. We'll show it to you in a minute.
Luna Love. Out top to Strawn. Fakes. Drives. Love thought about it. She drives instead, and she was fouled. And Luna Love's going to be shooting two.
Here's Al said coming over. Yeah.
Luna Love from the Netherlands, who checks in with us from time to time over there. I believe it's going out after midnight over there. So, welcome to Thursday over in Scandinavia. One out of two, love. 12-point Mustangs lead, 3:40 to go, third period. Underneath, sneaking away, laying it in. Excellent execution. That was Haley Paquette. Cuts it to 10. Down the lane, Moran loses the handle and then the ball. UMA's had a number of made baskets this half, coming off excellent execution.
Here it is. There's right here,
great,
Jim.
Great assists.
This is a trap.
See who got that pass. Who made that pass?
Paquette, I think.
There's a steal by Strong. We're going back the other way. Strong takes it all the way off glass and good. Emily Strong back up to 12-point lead, Mustangs, as we're near 3 minutes to go, third period. Allison Alley gets it across. Duzan comes in from one angle. Love from the other. And then Duzan somehow got back in the corner and disrupted it. Nice hustle, Reina Duzan.
Off balance finish, Emily Strong.
There's a three-pointer, Moose, that rattles off for Paquette. Here's Duzan. Duzan through traffic. Over in the corner to Moran. Ban tees one up. Bang! And staying up after midnight was well worth it. Over in Sweden for the three-pointer by Clara Band. I think she's got four. She's got three, maybe four.
I think four, Jim.
There's a basket. Good. I don't think they've updated live stats yet. So the Moose come right back and score.
Here's Band. Right in front of the bench. The bench is up. They've got it.
Second foul, Strong. Katie Butterfield's had an excellent half for UMA. This is Dunbar here. Nice rebound, Alcid. Ellis off the rim, no good. Rebound, Alcid, no good. And somehow Duzan got the rebound away. Love, nice catch, Strong down in there. Band to Strong. She fakes one way, goes the other, does not get the roll. And now they're going to call Strong, I think, in the rebounding action on the foul. This is not for the faint-hearted, by the way.
No, not tonight.
Or any part of the...
As you keep saying, watching.
There's going to be two shots the rest of the way of this period. Destiny Mora-Lopez in, and checking in for the first time, number three, Maya Nicholas.
After midnight, wasn't that a Clapton song, Jim?
Yeah.
After midnight?
Well, it all hang out.
Yeah, well, Clara Mann's letting the shooting hang out, yeah. That's for sure.
I think that was a good cover song by a number of groups. At the line, Ariana, El Cid. Nice touch. El Cid coming in, averaging 5 points a game. And she's over 70% foul shooting now.
Ariana's a good, solid player, role player for the Moose. Knows her role.
Sydney Farah back in for UMA. Under 2 minutes to go, third period. Band, shuffle her feet. Boy, the temperature changes in this gym about five different times. Huh? It was really, there's a sharp baseline talking about hot. There's a basket, Mariah Dunbar. It's hot, it's medium, it's cold. It's a hot game, I know that. And the Moose now getting their defense together, stolen by Farrar. And their offense is better this half as well, even though they still trailed by nine. Alley, gonna slow it down. Changes hands on the dribble. Alley off balance. And Allison Alley's gonna shoot two. Again, as we said in the first half, she's from Millinocket, Maine, Stearns High School. Fouls on Moran, her first. One out of two. Rebound, Maura Lopez. Maya Nicholas quickly in the front court. Down in the corner is Melendez. Back out to Band. Swings at the far side. Love. Here comes a three-pointer out of the corner. No good by Band, but Central Maine got the rebound. Nicholas to Love. Melendez for three. High off the rim, inside position by Dunbar. Sneaking away is Allie. Allie off glass, no good. Inbounds from the baseline, the Moose. Farrar across the lane. There's a baseline shot. No good by Al Cid. Came up short. Here's Band. Baseline. And walks. Let's see. Willette returns. So for the Mustangs, it's Maura Lopez, Love, Willette, Band, and Melendez. Farrar being watched by Willette. Skips it over half court. Al Cid, baseline drive. Paquette shut off in front of her own bench. That's Allie. 14 to shoot. 2 second difference between the game and shot clock. And a hook shot, no good, but going to the line. Allison Allie. Allie, 6 out of 8 at the line. She's got 10 points.
Mustangs have control of the game, but they really haven't been able to stretch it to really feel comfortable, have they, Jim?
It was double digits a couple of times.
Yeah.
Two-possession game. Maura Lopez back outside. Five. Band for three. Back rim. Rebound tracked down in the corner by Dunbar at the buzzer. So after three quarters of action, YSCC women's action. Central Maine 41, University of Maine Augusta 35 on Munzing Media Sports.
When I'm on the road speaking, I'm able to have sidebar conversations with everybody that wants to come talk to me. And I hear about their family and loved ones that are going through maybe cancer, maybe a critical illness, maybe something, being disabled from a job and not having the coverage that they need because their healthcare just didn't cover it.
I ask that you would allow one of our experienced representatives to come into your business so that we are able to educate you on the value of these very, very important products.
All right, welcome back to Central Maine Community College. On a very cool night, and it's supposed to be frigid the next couple of days in Maine.
Good thing we're not playing any outdoor games.
Oh, I'm telling you, it's some places the wind chill factor is going to be 30, 35 below, and that's the southern part of the state. But it's hot in here with the competition that both teams want and need. It's Mustangs with a 6-point lead. The Moose had a 19-16 advantage in that third quarter. Willette drives. And they say no shot. Baseline inbounds coming up. Let's see. See if anybody's in any foul trouble.
Yeah, Haley just fouled out.
Okay, Haley Parkett. Willette down the lane. Does not get the roll. Saved by Smedberg. Comes out loose. Love got it. Smedberg in the corner returns it to Love. underneath. Thompson is going to shoot two. All right, so Haley Paquette fouls out with 2 points. Three fouls on Dunbar. Four on Dume. How about five on Dume? As I just looked down, unbelievable, Rob. I looked down at the players, and I'm looking. The next whistle gave him a foul.
Hurry to the floor.
Right down the middle, Kelly Thompson. Thompson, the only Mustang with three fouls. Nice soft touch by Kaylee Thompson. Came in shooting 64% at the line. And thrown away by UMA, right in front of our Munzing Media Sports broadcast position.
Yeah, the pressure keeps up by the Mustangs, causes the Moose turnover.
Mustangs by eight. They have the basketball. Ouellette swings it near side to Melendez in front of her own bench. Love. Thompson from downtown. Bang! Kelly Thompson. She was 2-for-14 from behind the arc before that one. Alcid misses. Rebound Smedberg. Melendez. Now it's Smedberg for three. In and out. That would have been something. The two players with rare threes hit back to back.
The bigs hitting the bombs. We'll show you Callie's when we get a dead ball.
Bang! Nice touch by Sydney Farrar. Making her 29th three of the season. Yeah, Smedberg was only 8 for 27 before that one. Love stops, shoots, does not get it. Rebound Moose, trailing by 8.
Yeah, Sydney Farrar is going to be the focal point of the offense, I think, for the Moose.
Underneath, Alcid's shot is blocked. She gets it back and lays it in. Give credit to Ariana Alcid for hanging with it. And she scored to cut it to a two-possession game. That's Smedberg behind the arc. Loses the handle. Melendez picked it up. Love out of the corner for three. No good. Melendez leaps high for the rebound. Love comes under the basket. Thompson another three. Short. And out of bounds. Moose ball. Emily Strong into the Mustang lineup, replacing Mackenzie Melendez. 7:27.
Callie says, I was due one. Hit the three.
They get it over with about 3 seconds to spare. Handling the ball is Farrar, watched by Strong. Comes in front of us to Alley. Ouellette is defending. 10 to shoot, Moose. On the drive, Alley, off glass and good. And a timeout, UMA, with 7:01 to go. It's down to a 4-point lead for CM, 46-42, Rob Munzing.
Well, nice take here by Alley. Going to crash it in off the left side. We'll take a look at this. Really nice looking drive and play here as the Moose keep coming back. Here's the take by Alley. You can see her out high off the left side. Kind of plays a little possum, gets the high pick. That was not an easy finish, as you saw on the replay. So we got ourselves a tilt here.
Let's see. No fouls on CM. Two on the Moose. Right now, UMA has the possession arrow.
And two foul outs for the Moose, so they're playing with a depleted bench. But these kids are giving a great effort out there. Jim McClaw back here within four.
Yes, they are. Smedberg down deep. Bounce pass out to Strawn. Now they're going to move it back front to Thompson. And Love, halfway through the shot clock, CM. Strawn with eight to shoot. Thompson goes baseline. No good. Loose ball. And picked up by UMA. Here come the Moose. Baseline running is losing out of bounds was Mariah Dunbar.
Running out of real estate down there, as often happens.
Willette took a pass from Strong. Willette drives, tries to create. Nice block. Mariah Dunbar.
Yeah, Dunbar with a good defense, moved her feet, got in a position to get all ball.
Move your feet.
Keep moving. CM inbounding underneath her own basket. Comes out to Love. Here's Willette. Backs off, hands back to Love. Off Strong's foot, picked up by Alley. Allison Alley. Gonna slow it down a little bit, back it out. Thompson is watching her. Takes that long step, does not get the roll. Al Cid tried to get the rebound. Strawn had a hand on it. And now there's a block on UMA, I believe.
No fouls on Dunbar.
That's the fourth.
Fourth on Dunbar. 13.
Love to band. Strong looking things over. Smedberg sets a screen, and there's going to be a foul on Allison Alley. And Emily Strong quickly gets to that foul line to get herself set.
And a good foul shooter.
She's 1-for-1 tonight. 2-for-2. Came into the game shooting 72%. Does not get the roll on that one. Rebound Thompson. Back out to Strong. Love behind the arc. Drives. Ben thought about the three and shuffled the feet.
I think Coach Wrong wanted her to take that shot immediately. She's got four threes in the game, Jim.
5-point CM lead. The Moose hanging in there, even with two starters fouling out. Farrar goes to the far side. Here's a three-pointer. Spins off. The rebound up and in by Dunbar. It's a one-possession game. 5 minutes to go. Do I dare say in regulation? Band. Big possession here, Rob, for CM.
I think
CM.
So, yeah.
Love dumps it baseline. Thompson is fouled. Foul's going to be on Butterfield. Thompson, 2-for-2 on the evening at the free throw line. Now 3-for-3.
So the possession that you said was a big one may come down to hitting a couple of free throws for the Mustangs.
And she remains perfect at the line. Callie Thompson from Waterville, Maine. Allison Alley does a good job bringing it up.
Yeah, she's a terrific ball handler. Don't just clear out, let her create.
As I peek around coaches and refs, somebody took a three and drained it.
Sydney Farrar.
Bang for Sydney Farrar. Back to 2-point, band for three. All rim that time, rebound Moose. Getting up slowly is Dunbar.
Moose might need to take a timeout just for rest.
Allison Alley. Near side, here's a three-pointer. Off, no good by Dunbar. That was a good-looking shot.
That's Dunbar's shot.
Strong. The Love. Band directs a little traffic. Strong comes out. Strong fakes, goes up high. Score the basket. Plus one.
Emily with a little hocus pocus on that one. The hocus pocus move. Let's see, I think we got time to look at it before the free throw, Jim. Look at this. How she knifed her way through there.
Foul shot is missed. The Moose get it up with 3:45 to go. On the drive is Dunbar. In the lane, the shot up and good. Katie Butterfield with a soft touch.
Yeah, credit Dunbar's assist.
Moran to Love. Strong wants to go to work. Drives. And this will be Moose ball. They can tie and go ahead with a three.
Press breaker! We're out of it! We're out, let's go!
The Moose finally get it across. As Butterfield came out to help. Allie being guarded by Love. Loose ball over there. Timeout, UMA. Central Maine's going to be in the two-shot situation every foul. No fouls called on the Mustangs this quarter, Rob. That's big.
Full timeout, we'll go in the huddle.
You guys are playing pickup out there. If the fast break's not there, we should be getting into secondary and then play off of that action. We're not getting through the rotations. All right, we got four timeouts left and the possession arrow. You get in a scrum, just tie it up. All right, we got to get a stop here. All right, show 13, but we're in man. All right, let's go.
DMO 3, 1, 2, 3, DMO.
We've heard this from Coach Morong over the years, always reminding game situation to his players.
It's good information to have. Just go for the tie-up.
Never assume.
If you dive on the court and before you get tied up, you can call a timeout because he said we have plenty of timeouts.
They got four.
Or you can get tied up and we get the arrow.
Thing that's pointing out to me jumping off the clock, Jim, that you made reference to, and let's reiterate that, the five fouls on the Moose, no fouls on the Mustangs. So Mustangs can still stay aggressive. They're not going to send the Moose to the line, but the Mustangs are shooting on every foul now.
Shot clock says seven. They're going to get something off quick. Stolen away by Thompson. It's loose, picked up by Smedberg. Thompson, the Love. Love gives thumbs up. Strong in front of her own bench. Changes hands on the dribble. Goes down deep. Left-handed. It's good. Emily Strong went to work and scored off glass for a four-point Mustang lead.
The second hocus pocus.
Nice move. Allison Alley looked one way, kept the ball and scored to cut it within two. Willette stops, shoots, does not get it. Rebound, Thompson is good. Callie Thompson, the rebound and putback. Back up to four. And let's see. It's out of bounds. UMA lost it.
Here's the inside move. Strong goes up left-handed off the glass and home. A pretty move. And more action followed quickly, Jim. Oh, boy, we got a good humdinger.
Love, Strong, Duzan's checked in. Willette and Smedberg. Smedberg has it. Cutting in there is Duzan. A little too heavy. Kept alive. The rebound bounces around. Grabbed by Farrar off the floor. Under 2 minutes. Back we're down to 150. With the ball is Alley. Alley still has it. There's Butterfield cutting and does not get it. I couldn't see if it went in or not. Down the other way, it's going to be lost by Strong. I think Coach Morong wanted to slow it down just a little bit.
Yeah,
maybe.
take a little clock, yeah.
Pressure by the Mustangs, as we see all the time, especially on this court. A steal by Love. It is still Mustangs ball. Excuse me. It's Moose ball. They got 4 seconds to get it across, Rob. The Moose have 4 seconds.
Yeah, so what you want to look at home, folks, is you want to look at the 30-second clock down on our clock. Let's see what coaches got in the huddle.
Because you didn't go off 2 feet, right? You didn't get off 2 feet. Right here. That's the last timeout. We got 4 timeouts and the possession arrow. They only have 4 seconds to clear. You do not let them inbound the ball anywhere near half court. Make them inbound it back here, all right? So 55, pick them up at the gray line here, all right? 55, though, if they get close, you start to engage, okay? Nothing long over the top.
Coach Morong, very succinct, isn't he?
Yes, he is. You have to be. Yep. Timeouts are not time for storytellers. And sometimes you're not that polite during timeouts. And I used to tell my kids, listen, game day is not debate class, okay?
The ball deflected. Out of bounds by Smedberg.
Should a second have come off?
I don't think it did. Shot clock didn't change. Still 4 seconds to get it across. They come in, and they barely get it up, but they did it. On the drive, Farrar off balance, will shoot two. Sydney Farrar from Charlotte, Maine, which is very near Callis High School and Shedd High School, but she went to Maine Central Institute in Pittsfield. The MCI Huskies. One more. She averages 11.2 points a game. And she goes 0 for 2 that trip. Rebound Willett.
Now you think you milk some shot clock.
You would think. Love with the basketball. Duzant. Smedberg back to Love. They're looking underneath. It's all kinds of traffic inside. Willett backs out. Takes a peek. Changes the angle as we went under 1 minute to go. 8 on the shot clock, Mustangs. Strong has it deflected.
4 seconds.
The Mustangs will have it underneath their own basket with 4 seconds on the shot clock. Kelly Thompson back in the game. Inbounding will be Willett. Strong. Rebound. I think they barely got that off. Allison Alley giving up her dribble is Farrar. Here's a three-pointer. High off the rim. Rebound Smedberg.
Big one for Jade.
3 seconds difference between the game and the shot clock. And Luna Love will shoot two.
Yeah, Moose really didn't have any choice. Probably not the one you want to foul.
Katie Butterfield is fouled out.
As Luna Love's a good free throw shooter. So they've got time to make this substitution, and I think probably the Moose will take some time to do that because they can use this as a rest time too, Jim.
Brianna Dume comes in, number 31. For the Moose.
And Moran back in for her defense.
Right down the middle, Luna Love. Trying to make it a two-possession game. That one spins off. Nice rebound by Al Cid. In front of the bench, now off balance, the ball is loose. There's a three-pointer. Bang! Allison Alley, timeout, UMA.
Well, they needed a three. That wasn't a design three. But Allison Alley did a terrific job understanding the game situation here, Jim. This was, we'll run this back a little bit. This was chaos. Chaos ending up being a three makes it a two-point game. Here it is as we take a look at it on the replay. So everything's going wrong here for the Moose. The ball's tipped about. Looks like the Mustangs are going to get it. Farrar makes a good play back to Alley. Alley knows they need the three, launches the three, and hits the three. Big hit there.
So the shot clock is off, obviously. Game clock says 11.5. Mustangs still have the arrow. And they, since they called the timeout in the backcourt, the ball was advanced. That's a big thing for the Mustangs.
Absolutely. Now I think if you get an entry and a catch by the Mustang, you've got to foul immediately.
Yes.
Help over here!
You still might go for the steal, obviously, but if they get it in, you've got to foul them.
Nobody's on the passer. It comes to Love, and she's going to go back to the line for two shots.
That's the play. Well executed by both teams. Mustangs got the ball into a free throw shooter. Moose made the immediate foul.
There's one to make it. Still a one possession game, but now it's 3 points. This could make it a two possession game with 10.2. Luna Love. That one spins off. Rebound bounces around. UMA may have a shot for a three. They spin it way out front. There's the three. Short at the buzzer.
They got it. They got the three they wanted, Jim.
They got it off. Nice try. I think it was Sydney Farrar that had to fire it. I'll tell you, this game will prepare both teams.
Sure will.
For the final few games of the regular season, and it will help them well into the playoffs. Central Maine, 57. University of Maine, Augusta, 54. As UMA outscored the Mustangs in the second half, 38-32, after the Mustangs led the first half, 25-16. All right, Janai is already here. Where's her headset?
Here we go, Janai.
I got to ask her, did you run track in high school?
I was getting
did
the answer.
Did you run track? I could see it out there. All right. The Boynton Beach, Florida. Just run along the beach probably, too. If you got relatives down there, you tell them we're available to visit after the season.
Oh, of course, I got you.
All right, now to Rob Munzing for the serious stuff. Is Janaya going to start tonight?
Yes, Janaya got the start. Let me get the graphic up here. Got the wrong graphic. I got the coach graphic up. Here we go. So Janaya got the start tonight. Coach said he wanted you to start because he wanted your high energy, and you brought it. What do you think?
I think it's just about being a team player. My job is my energy off the bench and my aggressiveness on defense and offense, so I did with that today.
Well, you take a look at this Moose team. They fought you tooth and nail there, came right down the wire. You were in to finish the game. That's a good sign, isn't it?
Oh, yeah, it is. I'm kind of happy about it.
It's great when you start, and it's great when you finish.
Oh, yeah, it is.
Yeah, so moving forward there, that's going to help your confidence a lot. Well, congratulations on being our player of the game.
Thank you.
And continued success here. Go get them. You're like the Roadrunner. I'm going to call you Roadrunner.
I like that nickname, actually. I can take that one.
So when you go up and down, I'm going to go beep, beep.
All right.
Okay.
RC T-shirt's coming or something. We'll have to...
Fantastic.
All right.
Thank you, Janaya. Congratulations.
Congratulations, Janaya Moran.
Thank you.
Well, we're going to get we'll do stats when we come back into the game, because we're running late here, and our game is going to go off at in 1 minute. So I just looked at the time. So Jim will come back. We'll get a wrap up of this girls' game when we come back. We may even come back just a little bit early, Jim, on the men's game and wrap up the women's game. So that's where you're going to want to see it. So until then, so long, everybody.